Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anisia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. St. Lucia's sun-dried seamoss is undergoing a major branding and packaging change. Spearheaded by Export St. Lucia with support from the Department of Fisheries, St. Lucia Bureau of Standards and St. Lucia's Seamoss Farmers Associations, the island's seamoss is poised to be more competitive under the Taste of St. Lucia brand and with the new eco-friendly packaging. The Taste of St. Lucia brand features a special collection of premium food, beverage and wellness products for those who want a taste of the island life. The brand assures customers and clients that the products meet the requisite quality standards that ensure one is getting the best from St. Lucia. Seamoss farmers have remained resilient despite battling adverse weather conditions and continue to supply the US and the UK markets with exports on a nearly weekly basis, helping to boost economic activity along the island's east coast. The first week of October 2019 saw the most recent shipment of seamoss to the US, with regular sustained shipments anticipated. The parliamentary representative for Anse La Raye, Honorable Dominic Fede, on Thursday, October 17, 2019, opened the latest addition to St. Lucia's tourism product in Anse La Raye. The newly established Glittering Sands Beach Park, located at Trou-Langer, is owned and operated by St. Lucians and employs some 20-plus persons from the constituency of Anse La Raye. This facility provides water sports, food and beverages, a souvenir shop, storage facilities, washrooms and an outdoor spa. The project welcomed the first group of over 50 cruise ship guests for a fantastic day in paradise. Honorable Dominic Fede expressed gratitude to the investors for having confidence in their constituency. Please be informed that Cabinet Conclusion No. 913, dated September 23, 2019, approved the granting of concessions on barrels imported at Christmas in accordance with the following conditions: 100% waiver on import duty on personal items, food, clothing, toys, and other household consumables contained in barrels imported between November 15, 2019 and January 31, 2020. Electronic items are explicitly excluded. The number of barrels that would qualify for the concessions would be limited to 2 per household. There would be an upper limit of $2,500 per barrel on the value of items qualifying for the concessions. The items previously identified must be for personal use only and not for commercial use. The usual penalties and fines would be applied if the goods are used for commercial purposes. Cabinet further approved the transmission of the appropriate legal instrument to Parliament to declare barrels imported during the period mentioned exempt from value-added tax. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.